But I want to tell you about the Commonwealth of Belle Isle. Belle Isle is owned by Detroit. It is an asset. There are some financiers and some land developers that want to purchase it and make it a, quote, tax safe haven and a place for wealthy Americans to go and enjoy a select society, probably with their own security force. Who knows what it will evolve to? For more on all of this, let's go to Mike Papantonio, Ring of Fire radio host. Mike, this is a very dangerous scenario that could play out if the city of Detroit were to sell off this piece of real estate, and God knows what would happen if they turned it into a commonwealth and a tax haven.
Well, it's just, you know, it's the gated community we've always talked about, but you're right about it being an ugly precedent for what's going to happen going forward. Because it's not just Detroit, Ed. Washington under Clinton and the Bushes, they wanted NAFTA, CAFTA, SHAFTA, and these advocates promoted this international free trade. They were repeatedly told, Ed, that the Belle Isle scenario would develop, that what would happen is you would shift all the bread and butter key manufacturing jobs out of America, urban areas, they'd become a blight, and what would be replaced would be gated communities that only a few people could live in. And Detroit is exhibit A. And add to that this trollish desire of Republican creeps like Governor Rick Snyder to privatize. This is what it's about. Privatize all kinds of government services. Privatize transportation, sewage, water, trash, pickup. Create Belle Isles everywhere where you've run manufacturing jobs out of the country, where you've destroyed the tax base, and now you have this urban blight that's left, and we just take big bulldozers, bulldoze it all down, and rebuild. And not only do they get to privatize, but they get to steal pensions, Ed. They steal retirement plans from government workers who devoted their lives to serving their cities. They just wipe those pensions away. So your scenario about Belle Isle means all of these things. You see, Belle Isle becomes the metaphor for all of these Republican right-wing types who want to blame all this on greed unions, heavy taxation that's run business away according to them, regulations that stifle business. This is their talking points. Teachers, firemen, policemen are paid too much. And so what you do is you run all that and you create a gated community for the Koch brother types of this country called Belle Isle.
I tell you, it's scary stuff because as the wealth gets concentrated, they have the money to do it. They wait for cities to fail, to get into financial trouble. The options become limited, and then the sale of assets takes place, and then there you have a separate society.
Well,
and these people are determined to make this thing happen. What should Detroit do?
Well, the first thing they have to do is they have to understand that this is going to be the case that leads the rest of what's going to happen in this country. Unfortunately, this went to a judge called Gerald Rosen. Rosen, he was a guy that he's really all over the political spectrum. He, oddly enough, as a young man, he worked as a Democrat for Eugene McCarthy, and then he turns one of these conversions into Republican, where he co-chairs Ronald Reagan's presidential run. It works for Bob Dole. He just has all of the things that you would expect from a Republican-appointed judge. And he is somebody that is going to formulate the discussion for how you do this everywhere. This is the formula maneuver. This is the precedent. And it goes to a guy like Gerald Rosen, and they wanted it to go to Gerald Rosen because now it goes to a mediator. As you've always pointed out, the mediator is going to be a hand-picked flying monkey for the conservative right, and he's going to say this new formula. I love the way you characterize this, Ed. You really drilled down and said this is a Belle Isle story. It is a Belle Isle story, but Belle Isle story, with that comes all these other parts, and that is Kentucky, for example. They're doing the same thing. They're raiding their public pension programs in order to finance about a $2 billion a year tax subsidies. Then they go to the pension programs, and they're out of money on the pension programs, and then they're able to say, well, gee, we're out of money. Let's look at Chapter 9. Which Chapter 9 is this availability. It's Chapter 9 bankruptcy by municipalities and jurisdictions that's wide open for this. It is created to do this very thing. The only person paying attention to this apparently is Conyers. John Conyers understands how serious this is. He's asking the House Judiciary Committee to examine the use of Chapter 9 so we don't have Belle Isles all over this country.
This was in the New York Times. This goes back on the opinion pages. This was written by the Times, and this is this was back in February, I believe. Talking about there's three recent proposals on ways to patch holes in Detroit's budget illustrate just how desperate things have become. The first, and by far the most serious, came from Governor Rick Snyder of Michigan, who offered to lease Belle Isle, a city-owned island park around 985 acres designed by Frederick Law Olmsted back in 1883, under the plan in the works since last summer. The island would have become a state park with an entry fee, thus covering an annual $6 million in maintenance and operation costs, funds solely needed for the beloved landmark, which in recent years has fallen into despair. When the Detroit City Council President, Charles Pugh, insisted that Belle Isle is not about to sink into the Detroit River if we don't approve the lease, he was incorrect. And I mean literally, the city has not had the money to perform, in the words of the Detroit Free Press, the maintenance needed to keep the park from sinking into the Detroit River. It goes on to say Belle Isle was recently at the center of a difference money-making scheme. A group of wealthy libertarians suggested that private investors buy the island from the city for the nice round of due evilish sum of $1 billion. Yeah. And transform it into an independent, self-governing territory with the price for citizenship set at $300,000. Oh, the God. Commonwealth of Belle Isle would exist as a sort of free market paradise within 30 years. The group's website predicted the isle would be known as the Midwest Tiger, rivaling Singapore as an economic miracle.
Yeah. Well, it's part of the systemic failure of U.S. cities. This is happening for a reason. It's Grover Norquist, the idea, dry everything up. What you do, first of all, is you begin by saying all these people who work for these cities, they're responsible for this because we're paying them too much pension. You dry their pensions up. You give these billion-dollar tax subsidies to anybody who wants them. And what you do is you intentionally bankrupt the city. That's what Snyder's up to here. And it's not just him. This is systemic. Ben Bernanke knows that it's systemic. The Washington understands. Look, you got 80% of America's population, Ed, living in urban areas very much like Detroit. So you play that out and you capture Belle Isle all over the damn country. I mean, so the point is this. You can dissolve a corporation, I mean, through bankruptcy. That's easy enough. But you can't. You know, I saw this quote, I think it was by Kildy. He says, you can't dissolve a place where you've got hundreds of thousands of people who lived, worked, raised their families there. But the Republicans and the money people, and it's not just Republicans. Let me tell you, this is a process. This is the end results of NAFTA and CAFTA. And we knew it was going to happen. They were warned. There were reams of information written for everybody, the Clintons and all the Democrats and Republicans who jumped behind outsourcing everything, all our manufacturing jobs. They said this was going to happen. They didn't call it Belle Isle, but they damn sure painted the picture of what Belle Isle would look like, to where we become a series of gated communities where the gate is just too tall for anybody unless you're a billionaire.
And they will not pay taxes that would support public schools or any other projects right. outside of that area where they're living.
Right.
There's a book written, a preview of its opening chapter, has a hero landing on the rooftop helipad of the Commonwealth's 57-story Four Seasons Hotel, makes the entire scheme very easy to mock as an objective fan fiction. But it's not entirely a joke. Private foundations and deep-pocketed members of the local business elite exercise and outsized influence in the city as broke as Detroit, providing financing for everything from a much-needed light rail line to the ambitious Detroit Future City Plan, which would entirely remap the city and privatize it. I added that to the New York Times editorial there, which was back in February of this year. Scary stuff. Now you know why they don't want Obamacare. Now you know why they don't want public schools. They'll hire their own damn security force, and they'll have their own society, and they'll concentrate the wealth, and they'll run their little world the way they want to. This is what these people want to do. This is what the destruction of Detroit is all about. And who's behind it? Governor Snyder. This is the interview that should have been done on the Sunday shows, not the softball stuff. Well, what do you think of the bankruptcy?
Billionaire Utopia is the picture that you and Ed, let me remind you something. You've talked about this before, but now we're seeing it firsthand. We're seeing it unfold, and we're seeing all these predictable parts come together. And this is just the beginning.